Eyewitness News 5's Brandon Beyer joins us now live with more information on that cyberbullying. And Brandon, what's the latest information you're learning out of Chickasha?
Well, Jessica, you know, so many of us use Facebook. Here on my laptop here, I have Eyewitness News 5's Oklahoma page pulled up. That, of course, being our KOCO page. But now among teenagers, it's becoming awful popular, a thing called cyberbullying. I do need to warn you, some of the words in this package are a little bit graphic.
Because you're in fake. Best get your backup now, homegirl, because I'm coming after you.
That message posted on Colton Calderon's Facebook page by someone who used to be his friend. But after a falling out, this one-time friend now seems to be a bully, a cyber bully, defined by one lawmaker as where one kid targets one of their peers using various forms of interactive technology, including cell phones, text messaging, or cyber bashing on social media sites. In Colton's case, it's gotten so bad, he's gone to the police.
Said point blank. Well, point blank is referring to a gun. That's when I got scared more and I made another report to it.
But the bullying continues and comes also in the form of text messaging, like this message sent by a student who was suspended for cyberbullying. Well, my cousins from the city in H-ville are coming for you. It was nice knowing you. Ta-ta, good luck dealing with them, because me and my gang are about to rock your world up. For Colton's mom, who also has a Facebook account so she can keep an eye on what her son's up to, it's scary stuff.
It's very scary because, you know, you never know what these kids will do. And am I going to come home to my husband or my son being beat up or in the hospital or...
The school district hopes not, which is why one student's been suspended. One official told me today it doesn't have to happen at school or during school hours to be school related.
I mean, if this is going to go on until I graduate, then I might as well just go ahead and say, you know what, here I am. Go ahead, beat me up. I don't care.
You know, but the thing is, Colton does care, which is why he is coming forward. And so does at least one lawmaker who would like to see some stricter punishment for cyberbullying. At 6 o'clock tonight, going to let you know exactly what he has in mind. Live tonight in Chickasha, Brandon Beyer, Eyewitness News 5.